I'm over the community center in Paris, and we have free internet access here.
Right now we have 10 workstations. They're all Dell computers, and they're very nice. They're, you know, have a mega RAM and a giga RAM and LCD monitors, and they're really nice machines. Even as old as they are today, they're still pretty good machines. Some nice chairs that are comfortable for people to go in and sit down and enjoy themselves. Printers, faxes, things they can use if they want to print out and do other things as well. Help them with that, their homework or research, whatever they need to do.
My name's Charlie Stroud. I'm from Paris, Idaho.
And why do you come to the community center, Charlie?
To check my email and to do my work. I work from home, so I come here.
Okay, so what work is that?
It's for HUD refunds. I do refunds for the HUD. I send them out to people, and then they reply back, and then I send them the rest of the information.
What was the original purpose or mission of the community center?
Again, it was the main purpose was to fulfill the requirements of the grant and offer a place like that. I believe it's part of the grant to help the area grow and feel more comfortable with technology. Once we get people there, they feel a little more comfortable with computers, understand the internet and the benefits of the internet, and from that point they can grow and start getting it at their home and take advantage of it there.
Okay. And, well, why do you need to come to the community center to do that?
Because I don't like my computer. It doesn't work. And this is a good place for me to come and be able to access the internet and the information I need in order to send out the refunds. So.
Okay.
The community center is a good teaching facility. I mean, it does help people get in and not just learn on their own, but have other people there to ask questions about and grow that way. And understand the beauty of the internet. I for one love the internet. I mean, the information out there is incredible, and the way you can access that information, you don't have to look through 10 volumes of books. You can just get it right by clicking on Google or some search engine like that. The benefits to an area like Paris with the farming and the traveling, the things like that will just be tremendous.
This is work, and we're just going to go through the base, but right away I'm just going to quickly go through the menus, and I might move a little fast at first, but I'm going to come back to them, and we're going to do stuff together as a class using it.
We have different classes here. ISU has come and done some small business and eBay classes. We've had some genealogy classes here, and we just had a basic computer class. And we have a lot of summer people that don't have access to the computers unless they come in here for the summer and use those to check their email. We have all kinds of things that they use the computers for.
So just say file, and there's that drop-down arrow to expand the menu, or let me just click off. If you double-click, the whole menu will come out.
I do use this community center. I sell Usborne books, and so I come out here a lot to do my orders on the computer. But we've just recently got our own computer at home with the high-speed internet. And so I wanted to come to this class to learn a little bit more, and I think it has been really helpful of learning some different things. There's a lot more that I need to learn, that hopefully maybe we can have some more classes sometime.
When did you actually open the doors to it?
I believe it was June or July of 2004 is when we actually opened the doors. And we had a younger individual taking care of it at that time, and it didn't really take off until we hired this current person that runs it now. Her name's Donna, and she's done an excellent job getting the community involved and everything else.
How did you choose the location?
Direct Communications, an affiliate, had a building there already, and the front part was not being used, so we just used that.
Arrange icons, buy, refresh, whatever. We're going to go down to properties.
What would happen to you if this community center closed?
I would have to buy a laptop, for sure, which I can't afford because I'm low income.
We always use this click unless you want to get a weird menu like that one, and you right click to make a menu appear, but then you still just use your left click.
Thank you.
Okay, so you get display properties should come up, right? Does everybody get that? Thank you.
We have a lot of people that come in and check their email. We have a teacher who is doing some classes online that comes in quite often, and she will check her students and her grade book. We have several men who come in and take their railroad exams. We had a lady who got her GED. She had been mailing in her tests and everything just through the mail, and so she was able to come in and do that online and be able to finish her GED a lot earlier.
How do you feel knowing that, you know, Direct Communications provides this center and high-speed internet here for you free of charge?
I'm very grateful for it. It's very nice to have something like this because everything costs money nowadays, and us poor people can't do anything unless it's free, so it's great.
Donna, the lady there as well, has helped the situation and the atmosphere itself in the community center. What she did is go around to local groups, like there's a local photography group there that goes around and takes pictures. And she went there, and now they have pictures all over the walls from this group. And different organizations like that participated in decorating it and making it a little more community-oriented.
The Sharpshooter Camera Club has a display here at the center, and these are some of the pictures that they have displayed. And that's the Tabernacle here in Paris. Some of them are for sale, and we also have a few of our local painters that have done oil paintings.
You're having a hard time seeing what's on your screen. Like, sometimes it's really tiny. People put it on a big resolution, it's tiny, depending on what it is. Go right-click on your desktop, go down to your properties, where you guys already are. You go into the settings tab, where we are right now, and right here where it says screen resolution, you can make it less, and that will make it bigger. So let me just show you that really quick.
I'm Mike Pugmire, and I live here in Paris, and I'm trying to play the computer.
How often do you visit the community center?
I'd like to do it every week, but I've been missing some. I'd like to at least try it once or twice a week if I can get the time to do it.
So that's what Paste Special is for. Paste Special is when you can specify, okay, I just want to paste the text. I don't want the table. I don't want the pictures or the format that it's in. I just want the text.
I have only heard good feedback from people in Paris. We had a questionnaire and asked them what they're using it for and how it benefits them, and I was surprised what people use it for. Research, jobs, everything you can think of.
What do you mainly use this center for?
Email.
You check your personal email here?
Everybody sends me emails, and it takes me all day to read them.
Okay.
And then I send them over to somebody else about all they've done.
A lot of people want to insert page numbers automatically, or they want to make a header and a footer on every page. And this is where people always think to look in the view menu because they think it's insert or format, and it's not. It's in the view menu.
What did you think about the class tonight?
It's good. It's, you know, it's fast, and I'm slow.
I guess the greatest benefit is a lot of people can learn more about the computers, so they aren't as afraid to use them. And also, there's some people that don't have access to a computer, so they can come in here and use them. A lot of people have gone over to the library to use the computers, and they don't have too many computers, and they're only allowed on, like, for an hour at a time. Here, they can come and spend all day if they need to take, like, their exams for the railroad or something and spend all day. Or if they want to do work on their genealogy, they can spend all day long working on their genealogy. the center.
What are some of the wider goals of direct communications down in the Bear Lake area?
We got a lot of cabins and homes being built at this time. And so I guess one of the goals is to keep up with that growth and supply these people with technology that's pretty recent and keep up with technology's trends and go that way. Getting people in cable television as well, we are extending our cable TV area and supporting people that way. They don't have any other option besides the satellites currently. And cell phones, we're looking to get cell phones in that area. Right now it's really spotty. Cell phone coverage is terrible, to be honest with you. And we're hoping to fix that as well.
I guess I like mostly visiting with the people and just seeing if I can help them. You meet a lot of new people. We have summer people that stop in and visit.
Thanks, Direct Communications.